strangely enough, is the B-side of the new single.
It's jail. It can be worse. So you just don't touch that sort of thing from the start. It is utterly absurd to insinuate.
Yeah. The group Kiss, the nice guys of rock and roll, dressed in their leather pants, chains and makeup. Here you can see them on the cover of their Love Gun album. Songs on this album include titles like Got Love for Sale, glorifying prostitution, Christine 16, Almost Human, Plaster Caster. The song Plaster Caster is in fact a song regarding a groupie who goes around and makes plaster casts of the sex organs of members in her favourite rock and roll bands. We've seen blasphemy. Now we're just beginning to touch on the perversion and deviation that is inherent in many, many of the rock and roll bands today. Another Kiss album here, Kiss Destroyer. Again, the members of the band pictured in their leather costumes and makeup. Their producer of the band, in a recent interview, actually stated that the costumes and makeup was designed to look the way demons themselves would look. He had band pictured in front of many burning cities. We're actually looking at the Battle of Armageddon here. These bands know a lot of scripture, and quite often they don't let on. Now this band is very popular with young children. In fact, it's most popular with young children. An example of this is the fact that the Kiss comic book was the most popular comic book ever printed by Marvel Comics, and it was bought primarily by 9 to 12 year old children. On most of the album covers is an advertisement saying, enlist today in the Kiss Army. Send a check or money order for $5 to the Kiss Army headquarters. The kids are being recruited, and I feel that maybe the Battle of Armageddon pictured on this album is somehow connected with the recruitment, possibly even a big deception. Revelation 16 and verse 14 tells us that in the last days there will be spirits of demons performing miraculous signs, and they go out to the kings of the whole world to gather them in for the battle on the great day of God Almighty. Even the name Kiss stands for kids in Satan's service. Let's listen now to one of the songs on the Destroyer album called God of Thunder. Thunder and Rock and Roll by Kiss. In case you couldn't understand the lyrics, let me read them to you. I gather darkness to please me, and I command you to kneel before the God of Thunder and Rock and Roll. The spell you're under will slowly rob you of your virgin soul. These bands have become the idols of our young people, the gods of thunder and rock and roll. Young people today sacrifice themselves to their band members and idols by giving up their virginity to the members of the band. And as always, the devil is counterfeiting the word of God, where he says in Romans 12 and 1 and 2, therefore I urge you, brothers, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as living sacrifices, holy and pleasing to God, which is your spiritual worship. The young people are offering themselves as living sacrifices to their rock and roll bands. I'd like to read you a couple of quotes from famous rock and roll magazines, not from preachers, not from pastors or theologians, these from the people in the industry themselves who approve of these things. Circus magazine, June 20, 1976, talking about Paul Stanley. Quote, you know what we've been getting a lot of lately? Letters from 16 and 17-year-old girls with little Polaroid pictures of themselves naked. That's amazing. That's great. There's nothing like knowing you're helping the youth of America. That's Paul Stanley. Let's have a look what Gene Simmons has to say. Hard Rock Magazine, June 1979. Chuck Pollard talking about Gene Simmons. Just mention photography and he, Gene Simmons, will drag out all the samples of his latest efforts. All of them terrific looking groupies who went all the way with him while sharing their hotel suite. Circus Magazine, June 7, 1977. Gene Simmons speaking. Kiss has had sex with more girls than any other band, and I've got the pictures to prove it. Well, that's a little bit about Kiss, but believe me, we've only just scratched the surface. There are many, many other albums and album covers with graphics glorifying free sex and fornication, and I think many of the titles of these albums are self-explanatory. So